in Bahrain, where I've been advocating for human rights for a long time, and my citizenship was revoked as a reprisal against human rights defenders. I'm one of 40. On the occasion of the election, I completely agree with the gentleman from the EESA that we need to seize any opportunity that is offered, any solution that is offered by the Bahraini government to resolve this political quagmire that we've been living and experiencing for the last almost a little bit over 3.5 years, and we're coming to the fourth year. However, if it is a solution, throughout my study in political science, when I was going through my undergraduate and graduate degree, and studying the history of Eastern Europe, African countries, Latin American countries, some Asian countries, elections are not the solutions. Elections are a result of a solution. What Bahrain needs right now needs an immediate reconciliation process, need confident building measures, need release of all political prisoners. You cannot have successful elections where half of the opposition who started the February 14th movement, if we call it movement, revolution, uprising, mess, if you want to call it a mess, who started all this in prison. You cannot have successful election where, when there is a sectarian gerrymandering in the country, where the country is divided based on sectarian division. You cannot have successful election where torture is still happening in the country. You cannot have successful election where political prisoners, the numbers are increasing. What we need a serious dialogue. We don't need short-term solution. We need a long-term solution, sustainable solution, so we don't come here after 5 years discussing the same issues that Bahrain is having political problems. I have 2.5 minutes. I want to discuss one of the things that comes all the time when there are issues of Bahrain. Of course, we completely understand and welcome any positive step the Bahraini government takes. So the creation of Ombudsman was welcomed. The creation of Bahrain Institute for National Institute for Human Rights was welcome. BICI was welcome. Accepting of UPR recommendations was welcome. So what we did, we examined some of these things, ADHRB, the NGO that I direct. And what we found, the Ombudsman Office is basically not doing their job. We have came out with a report that where we studied or where we submitted 30 complaints to the Ombudsman Office over 8 months ago to see whether they will actually investigate them or not. What we found out till today from the people on the ground that volunteer with us, that till today those victims have not been visited. Those victims, their cases have not been investigated. The only correspondence that we got from the Ombudsman Office is, who gave you this information? Who is your contact on the ground? That's not the behavior of an institution that wants reform. And I'm more than happy to email you this report or even share with you in confidentiality the people who we submitted the complaint from, believing that this institution stands for human rights, not some short-term solutions that will lead us to nowhere. Also, the UPR recommendation that were accepted fully by the Bahraini government, we done another report on them, which is right here. What we found out that from open sources and from information on the ground, the Bahraini government till today has failed to implement overwhelming majority of them. Leave alone the BICI, which is according to the State Department, it has not been implemented. According to human, some international NGO, have not been implemented. Our own report says have not been implemented. Mr. Nabil Rajab's organization, Bahrain Center for Human Rights and Gulf Center for Human Rights, both of them have said that they have not been implemented. Ms. Chairman, I would like to end by saying this. The human rights community in Bahrain would love to see a solution in the country. They came here with an open hand, with an open arm, telling this body and telling the Bahraini government that the best solution is the Bahraini solution. And the Bahraini solution will come through respecting human rights and releasing all political prisoners. Thank you very much.